Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all. This is the video from chapter number 3, where the another family that is modified from the conventional vacuum tubes, that is microwave cross-filled tubes, we are taking into consideration. And the very popular device there we have seen, that is cylindrical type of magnetron, which is operating as oscillator for generation of microwave energy. So after understanding its working operations into the previous video, here we are going to take problem number 1 for practice purpose. So here we are provided with the problem statement. The problem statement is, an X-band pulsed cylindrical magnetron has the following parameters. V0 is equal to 30 kilovolts, I0 is equal to 30 amperes, capital B suffix 0 is equal to 0.336 Weber per meter square, A is equal to 5 cm, small b is equal to 10 cm. With these given details, we are asked to compute in the part A the cyclotron angular frequency, in the part B the cutoff voltage for a fixed capital B suffix 0, and in the part C the cutoff magnetic flux density for a fixed capital V suffix 0. So let us have computation for these three parts A, B and C. Now before beginning the calculations for part A, we shall be first of all noting what is the given data. So in the given data, here V0 describes the anode voltage, hence we have anode voltage denoted by V0, as it is 30 kilovolts, we have 30 into 10 raised to power 3 volts. Next to that, I0 is the beam current from cathode end to the anode end. Whatever the electrons flow, the operation we have seen, they are constituting the current for the output in the oscillator. So that we have denoted by I0, and it is given to be 30 amperes. Now as for the magnetic flux, that is in the cross field with respect to the beam that is directed from cathode to the anode, here the magnetic flux density is denoted here. Magnetic flux density is denoted by B suffix 0, and the value is given in terms of Weber per meter square. So the value is 0.336 Weber per meter square. Now there are two important parameters as far as the dimensions into the cylindrical magnetron are concerned. Here we have small a. So small a represents radius of cathode into the cylindrical shape. So that is equal to 5 centimeters. So that we can describe 5 into 10 raised to power minus 2 meters. Whereas another small b parameter is given to us, that we note here, it is the radius of when edge to the center here. So that is given as B is equal to 10 centimeters. So simply we can write 10 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 meters here. Now as in the part A, we are asked. So as in the part A, we have been asked the cyclotron angular frequency. The cyclotron angular frequency is given by, I mentioned here for part A, it is denoted as omega suffix C, and it is computed as E divided by M into capital B suffix 0. So here in this equation, B suffix 0 is provided to us in the problem statement. Now E by M are the constants with respect to the electron as charge carrier. So these constant values we can substitute the ratio value we have here. So by the next step, we obtain 1.759 into 10 raised to the power 11, we substitute for this ratio, and in multiplication to the given value of magnetic flux density, we have 0.336. So this multiplication gives us the value 0.5910 into 10 raised to power 11. So this will be equal to 5.91 into 10 raised to power 10. As this is the cyclotron angular frequency is always measured in terms of radians. Hence, I put the radians as the unit and outline this particular value. So this way, we are covered with the answer for part A in the problem statement. So after completion of part A here, we require to compute the cutoff voltage for a fixed B suffix 0. Now the cutoff voltage for the fixed magnetic flux density is given by the formulation. So for part B, we mention the cutoff voltage denoted by V suffix 0 into the suffix C we add here. So it will be equal to E divided by 8 times M into B0 square small b square in the bracket 1 minus A square by B square. The bracket is also squared here. So to look at this particular formula, here we have in the right hand side E by M, the constant ratio we can substitute. B0 is provided, small b and small a are the dimensions with respect to the radius that is also available to us. So here we substitute the values. We take 1 by 8 as it is and then put the values 1.759 into 10 raised to power 11 in multiplication to 0.336, that is squared here. So we put 0.336, that is squared here, along with b square. So it is 10 into 10 raised to power minus 2 bracket squared. And here we have 1 minus in the numerator, 5 into 10 raised to power minus 2 squared divided by 10 into 10 raised to power minus 2 squared, and the bracket is completed and it is further squared here. So by the next step, we obtain 1.759 into 0.1128. We make for the square of this. In multiplication to, here we have 100 as the resultant of the next bracket into 10 raised to power 11. We take from this bracket into 10 raised to power minus 4 into 0.75 is the outcome from this bracket, which is to be squared, and this is all divided by 8 here. So finally, the cutoff voltage we have denoted V suffix 0C is equal to, we get it, 0.013951 0688 into 10 raised to the power 9. As it is the voltage, we get the SI system of units in the volts here. So I outline this particular answer. Now after having the answer for part B, we get back to the problem statement. Next part is part C, the last one, where we are required to compute the cutoff magnetic flux density for a fixed V suffix 0 here. Now for the part C, the cutoff magnetic flux density is given by the formula. Here we mention for part C, B suffix 0C, it is 8 in multiplication to V0 into M by E, that is under the square root. Hence I put the power 1 by 2. In the denominator here we have B in bracket 1 minus A square by B square here. So here we have all the values available, we substitute them. So the next step, it will be, we keep square root in the numerator. It will be 8 in multiplication to V0, that is 30 kilovolts. We put 30 into 10 raised to power 3 in multiplication to, this is inverse of the ratio E by M. Therefore, I make it 1 upon 1.759. into 10 raised to power 11, and for the power 1 by 2 we have put the square root here. In the denominator, we shall be substituting the B value, that is 10 into 10 raised to power minus 2. In multiplication to the bracket, here we have 1 minus A square is 5 into 10 raised to power minus 2 bracket squared divided by 10 into 10 raised to power minus 2 bracket squared here. And after completion of the bracket, again we have to square it. So this way we have substituted all the values to the right hand side to calculate the cutoff magnetic flux density. By the next step, we write B sub x 0 c is equal to the numerator we obtain square root of 136.4411 into 10 raised to power minus 8 here, divided by, it is here 0.75 into 10 raised to power minus 1. So by the next step, we obtain it in the simplified form. It is 15.5744 into 10 raised to power minus 3. So as this is the magnetic flux density, the unit must be given, that is Weber per meter square. For the multiplicand 10 to the power minus 3, we can simply write it is 15.5744 milli Weber per meter square. So this is the cutoff magnetic flux density we outline here. So with the answer for part C, here we are finished with problem 1 based on to the cylindrical magnetron. In the next lecture, we shall be addressing the next topic with respect to the cylindrical magnetron. I hope you are definitely benefited by the knowledge we share for our subject microwave engineering. For more details like this, you can subscribe to the Ekeeda channel. Thank you.